He says at the time we were jamming to soundtrack, because this is me basically quoting Leo Da Silva's tweet. He said he cannot believe that while he was jamming to soundtrack, that Medhi was sleeping in the boys' quarter with cooks and all that in just one room and sharing the toilet. And he shared that when somebody called him greedy for actually, I think he was trying to support Cynthia Morgan to say, well, the truth will finally come out. He hadn't said anything then, and somebody said, no, they say your own case is greed. And then he went off to say no. He did a lot of things for them, worked with them on songs, and he has not gotten anything for it. So if it's greed, then that's where he should start from.
For me, I think what was particularly funny about this story was people's reaction. People, oh my God, people chewed him. People were like, so you mean that when I was listening to Chop My Money, you were sleeping on this, you know? So that was just what was funny to me. And like I said, it just still points back to the whole management of the of Northside Truth Records. And why would your artist be sleeping in the boys' quarter?
Ending with Baby's tweet on this conversation cartoon makes sense to me, where it's get a good lawyer and like look at the contract.
If there was this, okay, before artist, you sign, before you sign. But for these people that are in the ditch right now, they need closure, they need to move on. So something needs to be done. And as much as I don't want to call Juice the villain, hearing Medhi
and P-Square, it's Mr. P-Side, so it just feels like something he's the villain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.